kickboxing only. Let's throw kicks until I say stop. Right on target. That's on point. That's on point. Well done. Nobody's gonna be able to block those. You set it up so well. Let's keep doing that.
Stand up only this time. I need you to knock your opponent down.
I want to see more out of you. You got more. Move! More strikes. Let's get after it. No! Do more damage. Change it up. Come on. Dig deep. There we go. Knock down. Throw more punches.
Coming up next, a UFC welterweight division matchup. Well, he spent 7 years in the Army, and his work ethic and coachability certainly speaks to that. Now a welterweight title contender, here is Neil Magny, one of the better striking differentials in this welterweight division. Well-rounded fighter, a lot of different looks on the feet. He'll switch stances if he needs to grapple. He's not afraid to go to the takedown. This is a guy who fought five times in 2014, another five a year later. He has really been a guy that the UFC can lean on, and even in spots where he's been the underdog, Joe, Neil Magny has produced.
This guy has insanely fast kicking speed and ridiculous leg dexterity. If you are close enough for him to kick you, you've got a real problem on your hands.
Our tale of the tape for this welterweight fight. Magny is 5 years the elder. He will have a 6-inch reach advantage. All right, here now, the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Dan Smergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! Five rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist with a professional record of 22 wins, 10 losses. He stands 6 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Denver, Colorado, Neil Magny!
You ready? All right, ready for live action here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena here in the fight capital of the world. You hear so much from the Elevation Fight Team guys, Christian Allen, Lester Bowling, Elliot Marshall, about the coachability of Neil Magny and how willing he is to learn.
Very good exchanges here.
Magny works so well off of that jab. He'll be trying to establish it early.
Oh, that was a big left hand he connected with.
With a kick here, that one landed flush. Let's see if he can make some adjustments. Oh!
He's very wobbly. He's trying to hang on.
Oh, he landed a huge hook there.
Nice takedown.
Shot.
Look at this, takedown!
And busy as he looks to improve position here.
Excellent movement here on the ground. Look at this, nicely done. Inside control here, he's looking for the Kimura, trying to lock it up. He's got his arm pinned down. He's got that Kimura locked up. He might get it here. Look at this. This Kimura is getting further and further. He might have to tap.
So here he is. He has been a go-to guy for the UFC. Our tail of the tape for this highly anticipated.
You ready?
Round one. Well, it seems like he fights every other weekend, Joe. Neil Magny ready to go once more as round one gets underway here. This is a man with the highest strike differential among active welterweights. Gotta figure he'll have that advantage here tonight. Oh, massive kick lands, Joe.
He's blocking almost all these shots.
Well, he got cracked to the head there, Joe. He's going to have to change things up.
No! He tagged him.
He's got him hurt here. He blocks the punch. Oh, he lands a huge kick to the body, Joe.
Tries some serious power in that kick, but misses.
Head kick there, blocked by Magny. Trying to establish that jab once again.
He got tagged there.
Hit him hard with that hook.
Oh, straight right. Now he goes for the single leg. There's the single. He escapes up to his feet. Very nice. He lands the head kick.
There's a body shot. There's a solid body shot.
Punch coming. It's blocked. Under 2 minutes now to go in round one. Beautifully timed and placed kick there by Magny. Another takedown attempt here. Magny gets the single leg takedown. Well played.
Side control. Inside control, tying up that arm, looking for the Kimura. He's got his arm pinned down. And he escaped from the Kimura.
Final minute of round one. All working hard to get back up again, and he's there.
That one hurt.
Whiffs on the straight right hand. Magny gets hit by that kick to the body. Blocks the shot. Working on a single leg here. Final seconds here in round one. Lands a big right hand. Round two straight ahead.
Here we get a look at some of the action from that round. And here's a...
All right, round two.
Oh, he's trying to stay up. Body kick, look at that.
Oh!
Oh!
How about that shin?
Nasty combinations here.
Oh, he lands a huge kick here.
Oh, big kick to the head. Huge left hand.
A big left hand.
Oh, he is just teeing off here.
Oh!
Vicious, vicious punch combinations here.
Huge block there. Takedown attempt there. Magny gets the single leg takedown. Nicely done there.
Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy. He's doing a great job of moving and transitioning here on the ground. Full mount.
Oh, he's going for his arm now.
He's got the arm here. Now he's going to throw his leg over. And he's out of the arm bar.
Splits the guard and connects with the punch.
There's a right hand. Good defense there.
See what he can do here in the clinch. Joey missed with that straight right attempt.
Switching stances here.
Well, he's really starting to land a high number of strikes here in the second round. No denying that he has taken the message from his corner and picked up the pace here in round two.
Whoa! Oh,
his opponent lands flush to the midsection.
Oh, wow, Joe, that
vicious
uppercut
there.
Nice defense there, huge block.
Oh, beautiful kick there.
Shot just before the end of the round. So now he goes back to the stool, wobbly a little.
You can see.
Third round underway.
That last round was an all-out brawl. If they continue like that in this round, someone's getting knocked out.
Magny gets caught with that punch.
Oh! Oh, he's hurt. He's hurt bad.
Another strike to the body here. He's really starting to connect, Joe, on a lot of these strikes to the midsection. Magny gets absolutely punished by that head kick. Oh! Oh! And really starting to make these shots count.
Big punches here.
Magny's lower jaw is extremely swollen now.
That is a great sign of an intelligent fighter. Composure. Knew he hurt him, and he's taking his time.
Yeah, Joe, the finish comes courtesy of some outstanding ground and pound, and it's one thing to try to score when you have your opponent in a compromised position on the ground. It's another thing to try to end the fight, and that's exactly... The official decision is in. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta calls a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 56 seconds of the third round. Declared the winner by knockout!
Use your feet, use your head, use your hands. Slip, block, and parry. Don't get hit. Come on there! Nice block. Nice block. Good work. Come on now. No. Way to block. Great block. Ooh, good block. Good block. Way to block that. Now we're accuracy. I really want to see good punches. Pinpoint.
Good work.
Great target. You really touched him up out there.
Coming up next, it's a UFC or Taylor.
You ready to fight? You ready?
Well, it's always been a huge market for the MMA leader, and we are always glad to come back. They have rolled out the welcome mat tonight as we get underway from the O2 Arena here in London, England. Saffanine defeated Nate Marquardt back in 2013 to win the Strikeforce welterweight title. Oh, how about the output for this fighter here? A lot of good time shots there, and they're all landing. All right, first round is underway, and you know what to look out for here. The powerful overhand punches. That is a big part of his game plan. Every time he makes this walk, it is his go-to punch. We'll see if he can find a home for it early tonight.
Really threw a lot of power into that uppercut, but missed.
He landed that punch flush. Getting the hands going here early.
Wow, what a back-and-forth exchange.
Landing a good series of strikes here. Saffanine gets caught by the inside leg.
Just missed with the huge kick. Oh, good power left kick.
Timely defense there. Huge block for him.
Oh.
Missed on the strike attempt there. His stamina has really failed him here tonight. He's got to figure out a way to preserve some energy as this play. And Saffanine's lower jaw is just nasty at this point. Really swollen in that area now.
Well, oh! Wow.
He's got him hurt here.
Body kick, look at that.
Wow!
Combination.
Oh, huge kick to the body.
Oh, flying knee.
Oh!
This fight is dangerously close to being stopped.
He's out of here. Oh! He's out!
Landed a gigantic kick for the knockout.
Well, that was a no-doubter, Joe, and he's made a career of knocking guys out with kicks, but that one right there. Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Megan O'Leary, and here's what you need to know for your UFC Minute.
It's an old fight game adage that fans love nothing more than a knockout. If that's the case, then they will love this welterweight banger, who was celebrated today for delivering the most knockouts in UFC history. A record achieved thanks to his devastating prowess in the octagon with his fists, feet, elbows, and knees.
That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights. I'm Megan Olivi, and this is your UFC Minute. This weekend, we brace for a crucial matchup, which is expected to shake up an entire division. To get into position for a world title shot, this fighter has fought tooth and nail against the best the welterweight division has to offer. And while getting into a number one contender's match is sweet enough, if this fighter beats his heated rival to earn that shot at the belt, the victory would be even more satisfying. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
And coming up next, it's a UFC welterweight division matchup. All right, so here he is, folks. This fighter has been all the rage of late, but tonight what stands our tale of the tape for this welterweight fight. Diaz is 9 years the elder. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the particulars, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, ready?
Round one. All right, so the rivalry resumes here. Here we go with round one. And let's see who can get off to a good start here tonight. Maybe we'll see a little bit of a feeling out process. But both guys have said, don't worry about my emotions. Once that octagon door closes, I will let my skills take over. Let's see how it goes here early, Joe. Nice body kick there. All right, first round is underway, so as a submission specialist, you know what he's going to be trying to do here, Joe. Somehow, some way, take the striker down, set up his submission attempts. That is his bread and butter. We'll see if he can execute here tonight. Oh, massive kick to the body. Oh, straight right. Oh. Leg kick checked effectively there by Diaz.
Starting to land those kicks to the body.
Yes, I'd agree with you there, Joe. The kicks to the body really starting to do a lot of damage. Just over 3 minutes to go. Oh! Oh, well, you know about his kicks. They are on point this evening.
He just whips that punch in. He's doing a great job of mixing things up here.
Beautiful inside leg kick.
Body kick is blocked. All right, so there's a swing and a miss from him, and sometimes when you miss, it can tax your gas tank even more than when you land a strike. So clearly, it is energy preservation time at this point of the fight. Diaz gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds. Lands a glancing right hand upstairs. Diaz gets caught with that punch. He's got to figure out a way to get that guard higher, Joe.
Even when you block those still stun you.
And he gets the clinch.
Well, Joe, I know he respects the power coming back, but it looked like he moved right into that kick to the body, and his opponent landed it flush. So let's see if he changes up his footwork a little bit and tries to avoid further damage to the midsection moving forward. Oh, now he has found his timing. He is doling out punishment here. Diaz gets hit with a kick.
Ooh. Oh, he caught a big right hand.
And now he lands a combination.
Oh! Big straight punch.
Now they're both throwing with power.
Huge shot with the right. Nice takedown.
What a round. All right, so that's the end of the round. He got some things done offensively, but defense still an issue. And as such, the cut on his lip is only getting worse.
Here's a perfect head kick. And there's a kick to the body. Some really well-placed strikes on display in that round.
Brittany Palmer with us. Round two is underway.
That's a nice clean shot.
Pretty good straight punch for him there, Joe.
Nice kick by Diaz. Good job of timing this combination of strikes here.
Diaz gets caught by that straight punch. His defense has abandoned him tonight.
Shot a right hand through right there. Again, he's fainting with the punch. Oh, man, look at him now.
Oh, nice little sequence of punches there, Joe.
Total strikes.
These guys are swinging.
Whoa! He's got him hurt here.
He's in trouble. He's in trouble. Hard straight punch.
Lands a good combination.
What a wild exchange. Nice left to the body. Oh, he's going for it here.
Oh, huge block. Diaz going for the takedown here. Nothing doing there. So a much different approach from him here in round two. Took him a while to find the range, get in his striking rhythm. He has found it here, and as a result, has really picked up the pace in round two. Oh,
wow! He's got to be careful there. Don't rush in. Big shots!
Oh, straight right.
Nasty left hook to the body.
So 3 minutes have flown off the fight clock there. Oh, nice job defensively there to get the guard up. Shot is blocked by Diaz. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here.
Nice shot. He's hurt. This could be it.
Well, back to his feet here, Joe, but look at him. He is hurting for certain. That man is in a world of trouble.
Yes, takedown. He's posturing up here. Good punch.
Under a minute now to go in this one.
Beautiful punch. Postures up. Big punch from the top. Controlling him from behind.
20 seconds left.
He's doing a great job of moving and transitioning here on the ground. That cut is starting to get really bad, and they can stop this fight.
All right, that's the end of round number two. All right, that's the end of the round. He's got a cut on his cheek from that round. There are certainly worse locations for a cut on the cheek. It's not going to trickle down into the eye.
All right, last round. You ready? You ready?
Third round underway.
And lands a good shot.
Making all these shots count.
Lands a big shot from the bottom. That's unbelievable. Got the full mount, secured the position, and dropped bombs.
Yeah, Joe, safe to say he wasn't stalling or looking for a referee stand-up. He was looking to pound his opponent's head through the canvas, and he nearly did so with some of those hammer fists, man. He wasn't trying to score. He was trying to put an exclamation point on a most dominant performance here tonight, and he certainly did that as he ends the fight by knockout.
Check it out.
Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the...